This is a pretty even game. Like we both did nothing. He has no upgrades. What's he doing? Come inside and look around. We would love to. Look around, buddy.
Aww. Bye. Have a beautiful time.
Nope.
Viper again. Okay, now, like last game, I did well in the late game, but I got a terrible start. Oh, Camerva Slavs. What a sick matchup, actually. Both like farm civs. It's gonna be like 100 farm hussars on both ends, I swear. Emote only emotes, man. Those emotes, and let's go into this game. Hopefully no more first game of the day vibes in the early game. Like last game, I lost like two villagers unnecessarily, actually. Both of them could have been avoided, so. I got off to a rough start. I'm hoping this time I can get a much better opening. And that should be pretty well, pretty nicely done with Khmer. Yo, brown-eyed orc. Brown-eyed orc. I think I always mispronounce this name. Every time you sub, dude.
Keep it up, boy.
Dude, I definitely will, man. I definitely will. And hopefully next time I'll pronounce your name properly. Oh, boy. Yo, Geobeed, what's up? We're definitely going to clap some major cheeks here. Oh, man. I should masterpiece Viper with Ballistas. Late game Ballistas? I think he's playing pretty tryhard these days, actually. He's practicing for KOTD, so I feel like the masterpiece is gonna have to wait for when we catch him on a troll day. That would be quite nice, though. $100 dono to pronounce. What name, right? I didn't see that. I guess I missed that on $100. Oh well. Has there ever clapped him ass before? In AoE? Plenty of times, man. Daily. Hey chat, does Lithuanian's Relic buff affect Hussars? Nope. That's why I lost last game. If it affected Hussars, it'd be a steamroll, for sure. Well, I think that's fair, actually. If it affected Hussars, it'd be way too overpowered. I think affecting Heavy Cav is fine, because Heavy Cav still trade like pretty poorly against Halbs. It's only the Lightest that's OP, I think, for the Lithuanians. I think it's just a poor design unit. Okay. Go ahead and pick up that boar. What's up, Kaltim? Yeah, it would definitely be way too OP. Alright. I'm going for wood. That's kind of a mistake, though. I don't really want that. Okay, let's get a house here, I guess. Yeah, it's fine. I found all my sheep. Do I have both boars? I do have both boars as well. I could open Archer Rush with Khmer. I do like doing that, actually. Walling up, I'm going Archers early game. And then switching to some cavalry a bit later on. Some scouts and knights, something like that. Can be pretty good. Alright. Oh my god, Anonymous! 25 big ones. Very, very generous. He's saying.
Just hopped in from Viper's stream. He said he was curious to know if mixing in help would have changed the outcome. What do you think? Let's get a win.
Yeah, thank you. First of all, thank you very much for coming over and dropping the dono. I do appreciate that. I actually thought of mixing in helps at some point. Would it have changed outcome? Obviously, the Lithuanian help get an extra pierce armor compared to regular helps, I think. Or the same amount, something like that. I forgot, because you missed the last armor upgrade. I honestly don't think it would have changed the outcome that much, because he had that big ball of arbs. But it might have helped a little bit. Yeah, it might have helped a little bit, but I don't think I would have won because of it. I had bigger problems. My economy was never really good. That was my biggest problem. I think that's my answer. Would have maybe helped, but probably would have still lost. But I think it was a really nice game regardless though, I have to say. Okay, I'll start walling up that front then. The map is quite open though. I might have to wall like a ball. Yeah, I'm gonna wall like a potato. You guys wanna see potato balls? Coming your way very soon. Wall like that. And a wall like that. Just like a circle around my base. This is like the standard NBL walls actually. He loves to do this. Like, it's good sometimes, I feel like. It's good sometimes. It's one of those maps that's good. Why didn't Hera run lightest in scrim last game? Did you watch the whole game, Candy Cane? I'm not saying that to be like rude or anything. If you watch the whole game, basically you're gonna realize that I never really had the time to like make the lightest transition. I was always on the back foot and I was always trying to like pressure my opponent fast, and if I take the time to make a lightest switch, I lose so much time, and that time is what I needed basically. So yeah, that was like the big idea there. Gonna get some fast walls, and the reason I want to do this is because I do want to open archers and I don't want to get harassed by scouts. It's very important to full wall against scout openings. And it looks like he is gonna go scouts here. If he was going rush or something, he would try to hold me up there. Minerva, yes, thanks for the 100 bits. Happy birthday, Hera. Well, not quite my birthday, but thank you nonetheless. And emote only mode is coming in. Some cash that in. Alright, we're gonna have to support this fella. Is he doing men at arms? I wonder. No men at arms for him. He might not actually know what my plan is behind this. Plan is to do archers. Oh, that's a dead scout. Actually, no, I should be able to save it actually. If I run away, I think I should be able to save it. But I'll probably just get chased down because I don't have barracks to make a spear. So I will eventually just get chased down. That's okay. I don't really care. End of that to make a house. What I could do is also just not make any military and just let him guess what I'm gonna do and then adapt from there. Basically, it'd be a pretty good strategy as well. He might actually expect the rain just to be coming down. So I have some options. I think that's my favorite option actually. Just farm, wall up and farm. And then have him second guessing constantly what my plan is. Looks like he's gonna go for the scouts. No, he has a spear on the front. Maybe I should have showed him a range, but I think he did see the villagers being gathering gold, so he probably expects me to go archers. And so hopefully he will go skirmishers. That's like my whole plan. Force him to go skirmishers, and then I open cavalry anyways. Maybe some sneaky. What he should do for sure is wall up. He should definitely wall up. Instead of doing skirms, he should definitely wall up. That's his best approach here. What did I get for my birthday? Nothing. What are you guys giving me for my birthday? My birthday is actually coming up though. It's October 14th. Mark it in the calendar, boys. What's up, Hollis? Interesting matchup. Indeed it is. Indeed it is. So he's just scouting around my walls with the spearman. What is he doing? Viper, what are you up to? No, no, don't! Okay. There's no saving him anyways, let's be honest. Let's be honest. Oh boy. 24 hour stream October 14th confirmed. I'll do a 24 hour stream that whole week, okay? So day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4. And at the end of it, we'll have 24 hours streamed, okay? That should be pretty good. Yo, Daniel, thanks for the $5. Thanks for the 5, buddy. Saying
your birthday, you coached me. I pay Hera BB. Love you, cutie. Less than
is this AOC Daniel?
333,333.
Is this AOC Daniel? Give me the $5. Thank you so much, man. Never thought I'd be blessed with a donut from you, but thank you. I do appreciate it. And yeah, so that's $5 for the coaching. Not bad. Thank you. Very generous of you, sir. Let's get a stable out. Some scouts on the board, maybe. My plan is just to scout out the map, but not really doing much army. Go for a big boom. It's birthday gift. Well, thank you. Well, thank you for the birthday gift. There's only one Daniel allowed in AoE2. I agree with that, Yoda. No other Daniel should be allowed to, like, even chat on Twitch. Makes a lot of sense. So I think I'm gonna have the faster uptime because I didn't really do any army. However, I think he should be following me pretty comfortably as well. Look at the macro. Look at the macro. Obviously, I'm commercial. I don't even need a blacksmith or anything like that. Only one single birthday gift. Chat is so cheap. I mean, I'll take a gift. A birthday gift when it's not even my birthday. It's fine by me. Does this mean we can also get coaching for $5? No. Never. Way too cheap. I would get over... If I even show my face on any platform, even like Facebook, and I say like, $5 coaching, first come, first serve, I will get bombarded. Bombarded with requests. It's ridiculous. Like at $50 an hour, I was getting bombarded. Imagine at $5, bro. I'd be getting like family packages. I'd be like, hi, I have a family of 4 kids. I would really like to see if you could coach them each individually. Maybe say on Saturday, 1 hour after the other. Yeah, I'll pay you $20 to call it even for four hours. Yeah, just like ridiculous, you know. And now we'll see my stable, but I'm okay with that. Does he see my stable actually? I don't know if he does. This yarn, man. What the hell? What the hell?
Yo, happy birthday, man. I hope you have a nice time to take those.
Man, this yard with the early birthday gift. This yard, I hope you know it's not my birthday, man. But thanks for the $50, guys. Throw some hypes in the chat for the boy. He's been supporting me so much recently, though, I swear. Viper's looking around so much for me. This yard, thank you so much for the $50. And listen, on October 14, I will look at these $50 and spend them on something for my birthday, okay? Not bad. Let's go scout the map here. I'm gonna probably get a TC down and get a not with everything. Let's get a monastery down as well. He does see the town center. Is he planning to just push me here? Is he full walled? Is the question as well. He has a stable. Okay. Cool. This is a pretty even game. Like we both did nothing. He has no upgrades. What's he doing? Come inside and look around. Let's get some sneaky sneaks on this side now. We would love to. Around, buddy. Oh boy, need houses. Having trouble keeping up with everything here. Okay, just going to factory. No problem. Thank you. spearmen going out. Let's get some late castage knights here then. I wonder if he has any relics down or not. Ooh, don't mind if I do. Does he actually get this? Smokes, man. Drop it, dude. Just drop it. Distract them here so I can grab the relic. Take it and run! Rats. They go Halbaran now. Pretty scary. They've been faster with this transition, I think. Thank you.
Relic heist. Less than 3.
Quick Raiden. Oh wait, this is actually strong now. Wait a minute. I got a turtle up. Oh shit, he's coming strong. He's gonna kick my ass here.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm having still 200 pop. Alright. He's gonna go for the big hit now. His composition is so much better now, I think. Like, Halb's... Halb Cavalier? Not really, actually, no. He has a missing thumb ring on my unit, that's the problem. This comp might be better because of that. My Arbalests aren't the best Arbalests ever. Very little farms for me. Low amount of farms. I once again have 5 relics though. It's nice. I think it's just a matter of stalling it out. Not that much Cavalier, don't need to invest everything. Get some buildings in front of the castle so it's not easily taken out. Yeah, Siege Gem, they have to walk through the buildings first. Definitely a plus. That woodland is like one of the worst woodlands to take ever on my map. That should be a little bit easier to protect. And Hussar, nothing shit versus those cab. It's in the last tech, that's why. Yeah, I should go help myself. Ah, that's so annoying actually. Go back and deal with that shit. He was actually just walling out, potentially. Can't do that either. I've lost the fight in the back. Ah! Misclicked my entire eco! So annoying, that little area at the back. It's causing me so much grief actually. The game slipped from my grasp so much actually. This was that little area at the back. I have 5 relics, this should be easy wins actually. I feel like an awkward composition though. I don't know why I was delaying help so much. Since I help, the game is. Look how easy the game becomes. Look how easy the fights become, rather. Not the game, but the fights. Help is definitely the key. So much ass there though. Let him find an answer to these helps. He's definitely not gonna let me get map control very easily. He's not keen on letting me get map control. Ha! that TC will never get built actually. Don't waste the helps. Just wanna sit on his base here a little bit. Onagers. I have 90 bills. What? Maybe he's hurting as well. I just gotta get my pop to 200 now and I'll be fine. Oh, good rates, very nice rates. Challenging game near the end, but we managed to pull through. GG. Not bad. I feel like I should have walled one side. I should have walled this side. Like this side, this passage and this passage here were like here. No, this would be too hard to defend, but like walled this with this and walled this corner and then funnel the Hussars to the center where I had all my castles. Three castles in the center, four castles, but nothing in the back. The other solution was to get a castle in the back and farm around it so that he couldn't send Hussars around there. But this little like box around my base, like here, here, and then here, that little box, like away from any castle pressure or any castle defense was too much. He didn't do a good job expanding though, I don't think. He could have expanded way more. I mean, he had this hill, which is nice, but he didn't extend his eco that much. So it made it very easy for me to raid him. But I had five relics, so that was pretty game winning. The Bobby Getter, are Ballistas ever good? Yeah, Ballista Elephants are pretty good, but not on a raid build. They're good in like close matches, like arena, where you can mass them up and do a really good job at pushing one area. But as soon as you have to like raid on the sides, Ballista Elephants like kind of suck. I had like more eco all around as well, more vills. He never got the good vills. I think I was ahead in pop all game actually. I think I was in a better position than I thought I was.